I have this Foxwell 530 and I want to update it to update the SD card. You have three updates. The updates actually will add functionalities, but also the new car models. So here's how it goes. It's better not to connect it to your computer. Sometimes it gets error. Rather just remove the small SD card and insert it into a reader. I'm going to plug it into my computer. Make sure, very important, use the original SD card that came with the scanner. If you did a copy on a quality SD card, you still need to use the original one when you update your scanner, right? That's critical. And then you can copy it on another card. Right now, I did start Foxwell Software Assist. You need to install it. You need just, I have instructions how to start setting your scanner for the first time. Let me just insert this into the computer slot. And you will see the moment when it's inserted, it's going to, let me just reach for my computer. It's going to read the card. It's just retrieving card information. It's automatic, right? Okay, you don't need this. Okay, so this is how it looks. I'm just filming the screen right now, but you see it tells you current version. There are several things here. First one, it's actually Fox Assist. This is actually the version of the software, and it's important to update it along with everything else on the SD card or on the scanner if you want. So make sure you also update this one, otherwise it's not going to work. So it's just saying that was your version right then. And now there seems to be a new version in 04 instead of 02. But also I do have two cars on this one, Hyundai and the Volvo. There appears to be other things. I'm not sure what those are. But you see both the Volvo, now it's 24 instead of 20. And the Hyundai is 93 instead of 90. So it says ready, and right now you may also, if you don't see anything, you may also refresh, but you could see I didn't hit the refresh. Just make sure you insert that SD card properly so it's just making contact. We are going to, obviously you need internet connection, right? So let's just hit update. And it starts updating. Actually, it starts downloading. I believe then it's going to unzip, and then the third step is going to install. So it does take long, as you can tell. It does take long. It's not my computer. It's not my internet connection. Actually, it's the soft Foxwell connection to their servers. It's very slow. I don't know if it's in China or I'm in North America here, but just really be patient. It may take, I'll tell you how much it's going to take. Let me just stop the video for now. Okay, a small intermezzo. It's not finished yet, but it says earlier version is already installed. We'd like to remove it. I'm going to guess it's the version of Fox Assist. So let's just hit yes. And set up the text that falls to be installed. It's running. Kick okay. Well, let's just say yes. Whoops. Okay, so actually what this does, because I already did a one time like this, this is the Fox Assist. So the Fox Assist software, the new one, the new version. So you could see there was a running version. This is the new one that has been already uploaded actually, before it finished uploading or updating the rest of the program. So this is just for the program itself. So the rest, Hyundai, Volvo part has not been finished yet, but you need to finish install the new Fox Assist software version, and then it's going to continue. So make sure you click OK agreement. And I'm not sure if I do need to say yes. Okay, oh, let's say to continue. This is just regular things. I was saying in another video that this is Chinese software, and I'm not just going to paranoia, but In my opinion, just be careful. Maybe don't do this on your main computer. So let me just sign in again. So this is the new version of Foxwell. It doesn't say anywhere the new version. The SD card is still in there. Let me just type in my user password name. And this is the same as on the site. If I don't forget, look in the comment section. I'm going to link you how to install the first time, how to set these scanners for the very first time. Okay, let's see what's going on here. So this was Fox Assist. Okay, what you can see here, you no longer see the Fox Assist software update because the software itself that's on my computer has been already updated. So it simply updates first the software, and you have to do that. And then it, as you could see, it restarts. And then it continues with the update of the actual programs for your car, Volvo, whatever you have on your scanner. So this has not been completed, but you can tell the Fox Assist now it's at the last part of the this screen, and you can tell the version now it's updated. So that what it did all that install. Okay, so let's just continue installing basically the programs itself for my cars. Just click update, and it keeps going on with the downloading. It looks to be faster right now. The previous when I stopped my camera from filming, the update for this one actually took very short, maybe it was 1 minute or so, so it's not long. Right now I'm waiting for the other. I apologize for the shaking of the camera. I need to film the screen. I think it's easier this way for you to understand. Let's just let it finish and continue the video when it's finished. At this point, it did finish install everything on the SD card. It took maybe 15-20 minutes. The longest is the unzip it, because this one it's 100 megabytes. So wanted to point out that this has been done in the download section tab here, but it's by default, it goes in there. You may want to look for other parts here, purchase software and settings and so on. And by the way, this is the serial number of my card, of my code reader, basically. That's the amount that's being taken on a SD card. But I want to point out that this actually is not the complete serial number. You have the complete serial number on the root of the SD card. So this is the SD card content. You see the vehicles, Asia has Hyundai for me, Europe has Volvo. But at the root, if you click at the root here, you'll have this sn.txt. And if I would show you just maybe the first digits, this is the complete serial number right here. So this one, it's more complete than this one. This one is missing a few digits. In the sn.txt file, you actually have the complete serial number. I don't want to show you mine completely, but anyhow, let's just, I suggest you eject this little SD card so you don't have any funny issues with it.